and you probably want us to get going on these hot topics. Let's talk about the first one. Rob, as a parent, you were pretty passionate about this.
Well, I just thought it was interesting. So elections have consequences, right?
And yes, so one of the things, politics,
yeah, one of the things that I saw on my Twitter feed from ABC News was that with the new administration, that they've decided to change the rules about what kind of food can be served mm-hmm. at schools. Mm-hmm. And going back to the way that things were before the Obama administration, and all this boils down to that now for your school lunch, your kids can have 1% chocolate milk.
Right. That sounds great.
So that seems like big deal, right?
Right.
But it's so interesting because chocolate milk is one of these things that there's much more to it, I think, than meets the eye. Mm-hmm. Number one, kids love it. Yeah. We all love it, right?
This
it's
is
good.
Accurate.
It tastes, yeah, this is accurate, okay? We all love chocolate milk. But it comes into a bigger question because when your kids are away from you, you try and teach them how to make their own choices, make good choices.
Yeah.
But kids are kids. Mm-hmm. And they're going to, if they can get what they want immediately, they're going to get what they want.
Right.
So it comes into, I think, a bigger question of, how much say do we have as parents about what they're going to have at school versus how much the government steps in and decides your kid can have this, but they can't have this. So it turns into this very big concept thing that all boils down to chocolate milk. Because if you compare the two, if you have just regular milk and chocolate milk is not as healthy. There's about twice the amount of sugar in there. It tastes really good, but ultimately you keep eating sugar, you keep doing those things, and gradually over time, over a school year, over their whole elementary years, it can add to different things like type 2 diabetes, it can add to
childhood obesity,
which is big in the news. And then, you know, other people will say, well, look, there's PE, there's these other things, but look, it all starts with what you eat first and then what you do with your body after that. So I just wanted to bring up this topic because I'm sure that there's a ton of different opinions on this.
I'm sure.
Because number one, we don't like other people telling our kids what to do, but at the same time, it would be nice if people would back us up. If we have healthy choices at home, we should have healthy choices at school when we're not there.
Keyword choices,
exactly, right? And it comes down to choice, but I just thought that this would be a good topic for people, for us to talk about, and certainly in the comments.
So if you're a parent, I'm not a parent, Adrienne's not a parent, parents, non-parents.
Right.
Different
sides of the table, quite literally. And we want to know how you guys feel. Right now, what I'm reading is that under current rule, public schools may only serve flavored milk if it's non-fat. Mm-hmm. And so Trump administration is paving the way for it to be chocolate milk that is 1% or more, right? So once the changes take effect, and I'm learning, schools will have the green light to serve milk with up to 1% fat, paving the way for chocolate milk.
Okay, and here's another thing. Forget about the fat. Forget about the fat. It's about the grams of sugar in your milk because that's really what it comes down to. Number one, I don't know why we do this, but on our labels, in our life, do we ever talk about grams ever in the United States?
Oh, no.
No.
Right.
But when you're baking, when you're cooking food, you talk about teaspoons, tablespoons, cups, pints. So why don't our labels reflect the what we know? Do you know how much a gram? Show me with your fingers how much a gram is. We don't know.
I think it's like
we're not Canadian.
That's like asking me Celsius versus Fahrenheit meteorologist. I don't know.
Question mark.
Sometimes I question myself on that. But a teaspoon is a teaspoon. So every 4 grams of sugar is 1 teaspoon. So for your standard serving of chocolate milk, it's 25 grams of sugar. So that's 6 teaspoons of sugar in milk. Now, regular milk has, I think, 12 or 13 grams.
10 to 14, yeah.
Yeah, exactly. So there is some sugar in milk anyway, but you're basically doubling it. You're basically adding teaspoons of sugar into your milk and then drinking it.
Now, but is this good fat, good sugar? I mean, don't we talk about milk as like benefiting our body?
Well,
like really good calcium for our bones?
It has calcium, but again, there's a lot of sugar in it. But my question is, okay, so they're going to implement this 1% chocolate milk back in the school plan, but are they going to cut the sugar somewhere else on the menu of items? So are
or
they
amp up physical education?
Yes.
Like, where's the balance?
Yeah, where's the balance overall?
I don't even think it's about the sugar so much as it is about how the dairy industry backed Trump, and Trump said, hey, I'm really going to go hard for you the next 4 years. And then his stance on immigration really impacted Idaho and the dairy industry, and now he's finding a new way to be able to help them out at the expense of our children. And that's where I have an issue.
So you're, okay. whole different side
of this. But
right.
It's the backstory that really affects our kids.
There may be these things at play, because the other thing that people have been saying, what the school districts have been saying is this, that they're not drinking the regular milk, they just throw it away. But if we gave them chocolate milk, at least they would have this. So, to your point, if you include chocolate milk on the school menu, you will ultimately be selling more milk to the school districts.
Of course you will.
So that's how you connect those dots there.
Okay, let's connect the dots with our viewers right now. So we have Paula Jacobs-Mar, who's chiming in, says, provide your child's food and don't have them eat at the school. The problem is that the children that are being provided the school lunches and breakfast are low income and really need to have the opportunity to be provided a nutritional and healthy meal, as this may be the only meal they receive.
Very, very true.
Not to say that every person who receives the meals at school is low income. I mean, I ate lunches at school. I was middle class growing up. I mean,
but there's a lot.
Does she mean school provided, lunch program like is for huge. Free?
My mom was a principal at a school that had a lot of low-income kids, and she said many, many times with many students, she knew that their breakfast that morning was the first meal, that the last meal that they had was lunch at school the day before. I mean, and in all of this, I always talk about empathy and trying to understand where people are coming from. You know, these kids, they're victims. They can't go out and get a job. So they're in the system because they're in the system because of their circumstance, which is not their fault at all. So you have to have some sort of empathy about their situation.
So I did a story back in New Jersey about it was an elementary school who, in a underprivileged environment, started a vertical farming program and really impacted their own school's nutrition plan.
That's pretty cool.
And so whatever the nation's plan was, whatever those the charts are that say what you should eat, not necessarily accurate for creating a well-balanced diet, but this school stepped above and beyond and started their own farming program within the school, teaching the kids how to grow their own produce and then eat that produce at lunch. They knew how to balance them out themselves.
Well, and could understand that whole cycle of life and not just the food that's handed to you, you know, like you abuse it. Because they're saying that a lot of this food that's given to the kids, if they don't like it, goes in the trash anyway. So growing that appreciation, I think is important.
Another part of it is that they would have cooking classes in those schools to teach kids how to use ingredients that they're not familiar with, so that they become familiar and try to eat them. It's exciting, and I think that more schools should implement programs like that.
So you think this is more of a school taking charge individually or as maybe district-wide versus this countrywide mandate?
Yes, and granted, this was a charter school system, so they had the ability to do something like that. But still, if we're not happy with what the regulations are coming down from the top, then do something at your own level.
But who's, I mean, your parents worked in the school system since, you know, my parents are now as well, but like, if people have a problem with it, where does that start? At the school board meeting? I mean, is this something that parents can help control?
I don't know the real answer to that, because while my parents talked about education every single day, I wanted to talk about anything else. So I'm sure they brought it up at the dinner table, but maybe I wasn't listening. But here's something, a bigger concept. Food and your kids is a very hard thing. Because you want to, it all starts in the beginning. And then everyone asks you all the time, is it breastfeeding? Is it formula? And then it goes to, what kind of bottles are you using? And then it just keeps going on up to what kind of food? What about fruits and vegetables? Sometimes kids just don't want to eat it, and you don't want to sit there and have that battle. So kids and eating, just like kids and sleeping, it's a daily battle that sometimes you just don't want to deal with. So you give in and you let them have mac and cheese. You let them, I mean, things that they shouldn't have every day.
Right.
Sometimes you give in. I give in all the time just because sometimes you just can't fight the fight. So from that respect, in some cases, I'm totally fine with when they go to school that now they're going to back me up on some of the things that I say at home and try and give them only a healthy choice. So that way, at least, they are presented with something that's going to help them. You know that health and nutrition is very important, and it starts early, so it would be nice to have that foundation 24 hours a day at home and at school to back you up. What if now they're like, I'm not eating your healthy stuff. Wait, I can't wait to get to school. It's tater tots and chocolate milk all day long, and then I'll just kind of skim and pick and throw things away and hide food. I mean, kids do things because if they don't want to eat it, they're going to find a way around it. So if you had this whole support system with food and nutrition, it just seems like ultimately they would be making better choices, even if that's their only choice, but right. ultimately they'd be eating better food.
Well, you've brought up food a lot, and Lisa Wilson-Clark says we need to worry about the food that is sold and not the chocolate milk, which is what we started mm-hmm. this conversation with. The mm-hmm. food is the bigger issue. Courtney Rourke, it's chocolate milk. Get over it. Why are we talking about this? So a lot of people are wondering why we're talking about chocolate milk and why it's so important
to us. The only reason why it has twice as much sugar as regular milk, and if you drink that every single day, it just adds up over time. That's the only reason.
That's your concern.
There's a lot of extra sugar in chocolate milk. Mm. We all need sugar. You have sugar, but having an excessive amount. Imagine taking a glass of milk and then just pouring in tablespoons of sugar, stirring it around, and then drinking it. We wouldn't do that as adults.
That
we just wouldn't
delicious.
Do it. But that ultimately is the difference between regular milk and chocolate milk. I'm just breaking it down.
Should we have like a cupcake inside of your milk?
A cupcake.
That's what it sounds like to me.
Which kids I'm sure would want.
Okay,
wait a minute. Wait. Walt Gray is chiming in.
Yes.
Oh. I used to drink lots of chocolate milk at school. How come I'm not a guest on this show? Walt,
where are you?
Come over, Walt.
Now here's
it's about 100
while
feet
Rod
between
gives
us.
His commentary, you now, walk over here, sir.
Let me say some pro chocolate milk things.
Okay.
A lot of runners. One of my friends, I went to college with him. He just did the California International Marathon.
Okay.
After he does a big training marathon,
like this, like this. Go Walt, go Walt.
He will drink chocolate milk because he says to get instant calories, mm-hmm. fat, and everything all in one thing. His post-run drink of choice is chocolate milk.
But he just ran a bunch of miles. That's the
right.
difference.
That's so the difference.
Are these kids?
26.2 miles. What?
You,
oh, yeah. You've got a mic on, so what do you
I'd
think?
Rather speak on your mic.
What do you think about all this?
I think chocolate milk is great as long as like the non-fat or low-fat chocolate milk. As long as it's not the full-fat chocolate milk, I think it's fine.
Do you have a problem with the calories?
No, obviously, if you look at me, I don't have a problem with the calories.
The sugar?
But how about for your kids? This is a new era, right?
I can't speak for them.
As a parent.
No, you know that they're going to take stuff. I mean, you know that they're going to drink stuff and eat stuff. You just try to control it as best you can. Mm-hmm. That's why if they're going to have chocolate milk, if it's the low-fat, organic, non-fat, you do the best you can. You don't want to deny them the pleasure of drinking chocolate milk because it's so good.
But you want I don't have kids. But understanding how I dealt with food growing up and now how I deal with it as an adult, I wish that I would have had that reinforcement in schools about what is good to eat and
sure.
what isn't good to eat. And if you're allowing kids to drink so much sugar, or mm-hmm. at least giving them the opportunity, because no one's saying, drink this chocolate milk.
Right.
But giving them that opportunity, that's scary. That's a slippery slope.
I would say a lot of kids get bored with white milk every day. So they may not drink white milk every day because they're sick of it. So mm-hmm. to get them to drink some milk, you put a little something in it that's not terribly bad, mm-hmm. they may drink milk again if it's the low-fat, organic, or non-fat chocolate milk. At least it gets them back in the milk group.
Okay, I want to show you this.
Are you guys done with me?
Yeah. No.
That's all I got.
Check this out.
Thank you, sir.
And my cord keeps popping out. My apologies, but that's life. Okay, ready? This is what we're talking about.
Life.
And this is what I'm saying. Forget about the fat for a second. This is 1%. So this is low-fat milk. There's your 14 grams of sugar, right? So this is fat-free strawberry milk.
Okay.
And look at this, 26 grams of sugar. Ooh. Guess what has 27 grams of sugar?
Tell
Guess
me.
What's on par with this? A Snickers bar.
Stop
Woo!
It.
Yeah. Do you want your kids drinking a Snicker bar every day?
No, but that goes to my cupcake comment.
Exactly.
Yeah.
So yes, they are getting things in here that may be good. Vitamin A, vitamin D. They're getting sodium,
calcium.
I mean, yeah, exactly. There is some stuff in there, but that's like throwing kale on a Snickers bar. Like, yeah, there's...
But it has kale, though.
It's helpful. It's better than without the kale, but this is where you want to look. This is the reality. This is the stuff that's hard to burn off. This is the stuff that stays with you.
Would you rather...
Here's another one. Here's fat-free chocolate milk. Right, it's fat-free. No, it's got 20 grams of sugar. So if you can shave off 6 grams of sugar every single day, mm-hmm. even if you're bored of it, even if they don't like it, it's gonna help your kids out in the long run. But again, like I said, if you have active kids, post-running, if they turn into student athletes, they may actually choose the chocolate milk because they can get everything that they want all within one thing.
Chocolate milk has been called the new Gatorade.
Okay, so I'm trying to bring out all the info.
Lincoln's in preschool. If she has the option for any of these milk options or juice, what would you pick? Because they both have the same amount of sugar.
I'm a juice girl, but...
There's a lot of sugar there, too.
That's a ton of sugar.
She doesn't drink juice. She only drinks milk or water. Now...
Because you've
Right.
Kind of.
With that said, one day she's going to be drinking juice.
Right.
And she's going to be drinking strawberry milk and chocolate milk. She loves her sweets. We all love sweets. We're humans. So I don't know the answer to that. I just say you just try and give them the best choices, and hopefully they make it.
So bottom line, you don't want to see chocolate milk implemented back into the school system? Is that what I'm getting from this? Just out of curiosity.
I would say this. To say, here's the thing. Kids, yes, okay?
Bottom line, yeah.
This is what I think. As I'm trying to do the best I can at home,
sure.
I want my school yes. to back me up on one thing, which is, look, obviously one is better than the other, and when kids have choices, they're just going to choose what they want. So just back me up on this.
Got it.
There are other ways to get calcium. Mm-hmm. The need for milk in a school program is also very debatable. We were talking about kale, throwing kale on top of a Snickers bar.
Right.
Kale has an intense source of calcium.
Mm-hmm.
Feed your kid a salad. Offer up better leafy green options. They'll get their fiber. They'll get their mm-hmm. calcium. Mm-hmm. Healthier options.
But can you throw chocolate on a salad?
Like, I mean, what's
you throw chocolate on milk.
You could throw a whole lot of dressing on it and
you
ruin
can't.
The whole thing.
It just, I understand trying to get kids to drink some sort of calcium because I think they'll take the chocolate milk over the kale salad.
But that's because we're trained to
juice
it.
Right. Sure. I get that. You know?
Here's the thing when it comes to choice.
Right.
Everyone's like, oh yeah, choice is better than no choice. Fundamentally, we all understand that, right? But what's your breaking point? What about having a strawberry milk that has 30 grams of sugar or 50 grams of sugar
carton?
Or whatever? I mean, at some point, everybody hits their breaking point where they say, okay, we should not be giving this to kids mm-hmm. in school. For me, I think chocolate milk, if they're kids and that's all they're having, for me, that's just too much. It's just too much sugar. In one thing, for me, again, it's like drinking a Snickers bar.
How do you feel about unsweetened plant-based milk? So
almond
milks, cashew milks.
Right.
But can the schools afford that?
I don't know. Afford it. You
but
have to think
if they
about
had
the
subsidies
well.
That the dairy industry has, perhaps we could afford it. I'm just getting the political angle of all of this.
No, but that's good because that's the whole part of the conversation. There's many more things
at
play. It's not
so
just
many.
It's not just like I said, and why I think it's a good topic for the show. It's not just the milk. If somebody said, "Hey, it's just chocolate milk. Get over it, people." It's so many other things, and it makes you think about how it all works together, and if it works for you or not.
Mm-hmm. Right. And let's move on to the next topic. But I do want to say, I know ABC 10, our peeps behind the scenes. Let's turn the camera real quick. Joe, can you give us a little wave, or was that Chris? Who put the link right now about National Cookie Day?
Oh,
speaking of
that
milk.
Doesn't help.
They just wanted to say, hey, you know, it's another way that you can enjoy your food, I guess. Anyways, they have links right now on where you can go for National Cookie Day.
Or it stirs the pot. What do you eat with cookies?
What do you eat with milk? Deliciousness.
And let me just say this. My kids at home, we do the best we can. They do not eat healthy all the time at all. So let me just be real about that.
Yeah, you're
we're
not
just
up
trying.
Here.
We're just trying. Every day we have the same goal. We're trying to do the best we can. Sometimes you win, sometimes you lose. So don't ever anybody feel bad that your kids are drinking chocolate milk every once in a while. I mean, come on. We all do it as adults, so your kids are going to do it too.
Yeah, right? No adult shaming here.
Right.
No adult
don't
shaming,
do it.
Exactly.